Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to create a 3D infinity effect using only CSS transform and CSS filter. Ready? Let's check it out. So first, let's start with HTML structure. I'm going to create a container, then create a shell div and assign a class to it. And that's all for now, let's work on the CSS. I'm going to set the width and height of the container to 100%. And set position to relative. Then set the layout to flex display to center every child element. Next, for the frame div, I'm going to set the size to 900 pixels to create a square. Then set the position to absolute, while the radius to 50 pixels, and 5 pixels light blue solid border. Now you should see a round square in the middle of the screen. Next, I'm going to use the CSS gradient generator tools to generate the background color. I will create linear gradient using dark blue and dark purple. Then copy the code to our CSS file and place it in the body element. Then I'm going to add box shadow to the frame element. The first set of the shadow, I will use two layers of light blue color, one for outside and one for inside. Then repeat the code to create another set. This time I will use light purple color with more blur distance. And here's the result. Starting to look good. Next, I'm going to add more frames to the container. You can add as many as you like. Then in the CSS, I'm going to use nth child selector to select each of them. We are going to add a transform property to rotate them 40 degrees. And then add translate y and translate z. Since this is the first child of the container, I will set them to 0. Also add opacity. Again, since this is the first child, I will set it to 1. Then repeat the code to match the number of the frame element you added in HTML. And for each one, I will gradually increase the translate y and decrease the translate z and opacity. This will take some time, so I will fast forward this video. Okay, let's see the result. The reason it's a mess is because we haven't set the perspective property of the container. So the browser tried to render our transform as 2D. Well, let's go back and add it. I will add 50 pixel perspective for this tutorial. And also add CSS filter to increase the brightness and contrast of the shadow for aesthetic. Looks good. You can try changing the perspective amount to experiment different viewing angle. Now the final step is to add the animation. First, create a keyframe animation. Then change the brightness and contrast a little bit. and add the animation property to all frame elements. An important step is to add the animation delay to each of them and gradually increase the delay. Again, this takes some time, so let's fast forward. Now for the zooming effect, I will add an animation to change the perspective amount of the container. And that's all for this tutorial, hope you guys enjoy. If you want to see more web development tips and tutorials, subscribe this channel to stay tuned for weekly update. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Bye!